Hello everyone, I hope you are all well. Thank you for watching. In this video, I want to talk about acceptance and how accepting how we feel is the start of just everything. I believe that if we don't accept the way we feel, whether it's a good thing or a bad thing that we feel, then it's very difficult to start a healing journey. I think we have to be very honest with ourselves, and it's actually very difficult to do. But if we don't face ourselves and recognize that maybe we don't feel well, or we feel sad, we feel heartbroken, we feel angry, we feel many other things, then I think it's very difficult to start working on ourselves. Because when we refuse to feel and accept the way we feel, then we are going to start working, try to heal, but we are going to be in disconnect with what we feel inside. And, maybe, for example, you're going through, a difficult time, and you're going through a breakup, and you feel angry, you feel upset, you feel sad, you miss the person, you maybe still love them. And if you just ignore what you feel, I think it's going to be very hard to truly heal your heart. I really believe you have to accept what you feel. And that's just not from my own personal experience, but that's me, talking to my counselor for a year. It's me watching a lot of like motivational speakers and reading self-help books and things like that. I think you gotta sit down and be real with yourself. And you know what? So what if you feel upset? So what if you feel sad? So what if you still love the person who broke your heart? It doesn't, it doesn't matter. It's better that you're honest with yourself so that you can really start working on these emotions. And there is nothing wrong with feeling the way you feel. You know, if you are heartbroken and if you're sad, if you're missing someone you love, then isn't it normal? Because maybe you were in a relationship and then you got your heart broken, or maybe you still have hope that you can be back with the person. And so what? If you love them, what is wrong with that? Don't listen to what people say on whether it's right or wrong what you feel. Some people can't understand, because the best person who can understand it is you, because you are in that situation right now. And you're the one who were maybe sharing a relationship with someone for many years, and you know the depth of your love, for example, or your attachment to that person, or the memories that you have. So I'd like you to be very honest with yourself. And if you are honest with yourself, you're going to find different solutions, right? If you miss someone, what can you do about it? If you feel upset, what can you do about it? If you feel hurt, what can you do about it? So to really heal and find the real solution, you need to look at the real problems or the real feelings within yourself. Another starting point, which I talked about many times in my videos, is to know that you cannot change what happened. And if you live in bitterness, in anger towards yourself or towards, the other person, it's going to prevent you from moving through the pain. When we stay bitter and angry with ourselves or with other people, it really prevents us from healing. And that doesn't mean that you're never going to feel upset or hurt or anything. Of course, there's going to be ups and downs. But being also honest with this feeling, forgiving yourself, forgiving the other person, is very important. You know you cannot change what happened. You cannot take back the words that have been spoken. You cannot delete the action that have been made. You cannot change what you did or what you say. And you cannot change what someone did or said to you. And for that reason, if you keep repeating things in your head, you're never gonna get out of it. Maybe the situation is not completely lost. If you want to give it a chance, or if you want it to be an opportunity rather than a stuck situation, then you're gonna have to step out of it. It's the past. You have to recognize what you did wrong, what the person did wrong. You take it and you put it aside. That is not who you are today. If you choose that, it's not that person that you are today. It doesn't have to be who you are going to be tomorrow. It's a choice. And I know it feels like it's our identity that we are like that. We did this, so we are bad, or they did this and they are bad. But life is moving and time is moving as well. It's not fixed, and you can transform yourself. The person can transform themselves. And so rather than being stuck in that, just take that situation, acknowledge the fact that's what happened, and leave it in the past where it belongs. Otherwise, you're not going to be able to, you know, make a step forward and start your healing. So it's very important to also keep in mind that you don't know what's going to happen in the future. If you work on yourself, if you transform this as a challenge, as an opportunity, if you leave the bad things in the past, who knows what can happen in the future? Please bear in mind that the future can have even better things, much better thing than the hurt and pain or the bad things that you did or people did to you. You don't know. See it as a chance. Right. I hope that makes sense. Have a good day wherever you are, and I speak to you soon.